The city of grandeur, Moscow, took centuries of building, and the leaders often didn't hesitate to sacrifice their people for bigger things. Joseph Stalin killed millions, but before, he got rid of his opposition. And this building right here is now a concert hall. It used to be the House of Soviets, and that is where the Moscow show trials took center stage 70 years ago.
The enemies of the people, as they were branded, Zinoviev, Kamenev and other key Bolsheviks facing trial. They didn't agree with Stalin. They wanted socialism worldwide. Stalin wanted one communist superstate. Stalin started a campaign to eliminate all Bolsheviks who took part in 1917 revolution, accused of crimes from espionage and sabotage to forming a terrorist organization to assassinate Stalin. They all confessed.
There was no conspiracy, no threat to Stalin's life. Stalin was sensitive to disapproval and he eliminated any division within the Communist Party.
Lubyanka, a successor to the KGB, the FSB is here now, and decades back this is where the accused and their families were interrogated and their confessions extorted. Later they were executed. And just a few hundred meters away from Lubyanka, on this little side street, we found the gates, which hundreds went in through, but never came out of.
His only fault was his proximity to Lenin, says the daughter of Bolshevik Serebryakov, who was among the first to be accused at the show trial. She was 13 when her father was executed.
We say Stalin's repressions, but we don't realize repressions are a form of punishment. But my father was punished for a crime he did not and could not commit. And later people were shot without trial, without paperwork or any explanation.
This house on the embankment of the Moscow River saw the first mass arrests following the show trials. It was built specially for high-level party officials, and virtually every night, black cars came for its residents.
This house used to be like a merry village. Everyone knew each other, what's cooking at which flat, but 1937 changed it all. People became enemies.
The mood of hostility and suspicion spread beyond this house yard, and in fear of accusations coming their way, the people showed no mercy for the accused.
They tried to get rid of our beloved Stalin, says this factory worker. Death to traitors of the motherland. The cult of Stalin grew in strength as the leader consolidated his power. He now had no obstacles to his way of leading the country. Despite the damage of the great purges, some even today say Russia owes its industrial base to Stalin.
There was no other way but Stalin's way. In a decade, we leaped economically like no other country in world history.
But the superstate Stalin took part in building collapsed in 1991, and he's now here at this open-air museum just across from Gorky Park in Moscow. Still larger than life, cast in marble, intimidating. For most coming here, he's just a character from history books. But 70 years later, there are still those too afraid to look into his eyes. Anastasia Khadulina, Russia Today, Moscow.